see from planet to planet and star to shining star. This is Dr. Sean David Morton. Welcome to the Strange Universe Radio Prison Edition. Look, I've got a big thing for all of you. We've got a lot of interesting stuff happening, a lot of stuff politically, not a lot of stuff geographically, a lot of things, but I really need your help. Everybody out there has been talking about, Sean, how can we help you? What can we do? The only reason I've been in here so long, I've explained to people, is because my appeal has taken so long. It took me 8 months to get discovery. It took me another almost 8 months to not have an attorney. So anyway, my appeal is pending. Everything's done in the appeal. It's just waiting for the ruling of the Ninth Circuit Court that I'm convinced is going to overturn this case, because it's just such a mess. But here's what's happening. Under the First Step Act, which was passed by Donald Trump on December 21st of 2018, and because of my health and because the BOP has blinded me due to their dereliction and malfeasance and basically just criminal neglect, I'm blind in my right eye, and it's getting worse, and I need to get out of here to actually get the proper medical care that I need. So I have a hearing coming up on November 18th, which is a motion for compassionate release based on the new guidelines of the First Step Act. My response to the government's opposition is due on October 25th. Here's what I need from everybody. I need everybody to go to the websites, do whatever it is you need to do, and I need you to just write an email, if you could. And the email needs to basically say, Dear Honorable Judge Stephen V. Wilson, and you need to simply say, number one, what is it you do for a living? Number two, what have I said or done throughout my 30-plus year radio career, 26 million people on Art Bell, you know, the number nine biggest radio show on Revolution Radio, with the blast that I've been doing here, all the volunteer stuff that I've done? What have I ever done or said that's ever had an effect on you, that's ever maybe helped you, or any opinion that you have? And number three is, why do you think they should let me out of prison? Not only because of my medical condition, but because of all the other things I have to do and work I have to do and all that. You need to send that. So once again, letter to the judge, Stephen V. Wilson, in the form of an email, what you do, what have I done to affect you, and why do you think I should get out of prison? And you need to send this email to Melissa Morton 777 at gmail.com. That's Melissa Morton 777 at gmail.com. One more time, Melissa Morton 777 at gmail.com. That will help me, and we're trying to get several hundred of these emails and letters to be sent to Judge Wilson and for my hearing on compassionate release on November 18th, and we'll see what happens. The great thing about it is that the response has been done by these guys at the DOJ. They haven't even read the First Step Act. It's just to give you an idea, as of this month, the United States has now surpassed Stalin in more people in prison than at the height of Stalin's gulags. In just the federal system alone, there's 221,000 people in the system. There's 186,000 people that are currently incarcerated, which, again, makes Stalin look like a piker for people that are actually in jail. The point of the First Step Act was to release nonviolent, non-drug, non-sex, non-guns, non-whatever, basically guys in camps like I am, which are no walls, no security, to bypass the Administrative Procedures Act and the Byzantine labyrinthine maze that they put you through, so that all you have to do now is write a letter to the wardeness. Well, we have a wardeness here, wardeness Barbara von Blankensee, and who I think in the TV series, the Club Fed TV series that I'm writing, they're going to have Heather Locklear play her, I suppose. But to cut through the morass of the Administrative Procedures Act, because the BOP wasn't letting anybody go. And now after 30 days, you write the letter. It doesn't matter if she accepts it or rejects it. And it goes directly to the court. And now the court gets to decide, how long you should stay in. It's also allowing me to raise, the First Step Act actually allows you to raise evidence that was not known to the sentencing court at the time of sentencing. Well, it turns out that the DOJ hid the fact that they used my wife and I, Melissa, as victims to put three other people in jail, people who were licensed tax preparers and CPAs, and then they turned around and tried to claim that we were the perpetrators and the architects of the entire scheme, which was really nothing more than filling out the IRS's paperwork and getting a return. And the IRS didn't like it because you were taking money away from the banks, which is taxes that the banks were supposed to pay. But, you know, that's neither here nor there. So that's all my legal stuff for right now. Once again, Judge Stephen V. Wilson, what you do, what about me, what effect have I had on you, and why do you think I can get out of jail? Melissa Morton, 777 at gmail.com. All right, now here's the big thing that's going on right now. Now, because we had some technical communications problems, and we weren't able to do, they've got us all locked down right now, so we're all just staying in the house, and they turned off the phones. But because this is the first time I've had a chance to talk about this, I got kind of scooped by Ben Fulford and Stephen Quayle and everybody out there. But right now what's happened is that from the Marine Corps website, this is right off the Marines website, they're now saying manpower guidance for activation and deactivation of reserve component, RC, Marines ordered to active duty defense support of civil authorities. So what's happening is that the Marines are all being called in, and let me read you actually from the excerpts of this act, 2B2, when directed by the President in support of a request for assistance from a primary federal department or agency, 2B3, a request for forces from the responsible combatant commander, 2C, a commander's immediate response authority to save lives, prevent human suffering, or mitigate great property damage within the United States is set forth in REFA, commander shall comply, this MAR admin, Marine Corps Administration, and any supplemental direction provided by higher headquarters. So unless prohibited by EPLO, it's saying that now people can volunteer authority in lieu of activation. Basically, Trump is activating the Marine Corps, and it's the Marine Corps to back up civil authority. So this goes into effect on October 19th. So something big is about ready to come down. Now, there's a lot of people that are wondering about what this could be. Could it be that you've got these 118,000 still sealed federal indictments that are just sitting on PACER? And look, I can confirm to you, I've looked at them on PACER. They're there, but they're just sitting there, and they're waiting for somebody like William Barr to eventually pull the trigger. The challenge with Barr is that he's just another deep state swamp monster. This is the guy that covered up for the Bush administration for Iran-Contra. This is the guy that covered up for the FBI and the BATF when they blew Vicki Weaver's head off at Ruby Ridge. This is the guy that covered for Lon Hirachi, who was the sniper that blew out Vicki Weaver's brains as she was breastfeeding her baby and stuck her head up in a window, and Lon Hirachi blew her head off. And not only did Lon Hirachi not go to jail, he got a commendation from the ATF. And then, some years later, he was the guy that was manning the machine gun that as women and children were fleeing the main complex building at Waco when they set the place on fire, they showed video, FLIR video, of Lon Hirachi sitting basically in a machine gun nest, machine gunning all these women and children actually coming, the Branch Davidians actually coming out of it. And not only is this murderous son of a bitch not in jail, but they're giving him medals, and he actually appeared on the cover of like Guns and Ammo magazine. Yeah, when I'm killing babies or shooting women's heads off while they're feeding babies, this is the gun that I use. So I don't understand what's going on with Trump as far as him picking these guys that, again, are nothing but deep state cover-up guys. And if he thinks he's getting any justice at a bar, he's got another thing coming. Now, maybe he's finally catching on to this impeachment nonsense. Now, here's another interesting thing. Hillary Clinton, back in it again. You've had about 27 to 30 people all die around her in about the last year or so, including her brother, by the way. And now Hillary's actually talking about running for president again. Well, I had a woman on my show years ago who wrote a book about Hillary who basically says that the one thing that's keeping Hillary out of prison is the fact that she's running for president of the United States. I think that she's feeling the noose tighten around her neck, and I would not be too surprised if she says, well, I'm thinking about running, or I'm coming back in. I mean, she may not make a statement like that. But let me give you a lot of astrological stuff about 2020 coming up. First off, for the Mormons out there, 2020 is going to be the 200th anniversary of the first meeting of Joseph Smith with the angel Moroni, who claimed that he was a man, and he went to the Pleiades, and he's back now. So kind of another extraterrestrial space religion. But Joseph Smith said 200 years after these prophecies that there would be some gigantic things that are going to start happening in the United States. Now, I don't know quite, I'll give you a further updates as to what those prophecies are, but I think it's fascinating is that the fact that if you look at the astrology of the United States, and you astrologers out there can check it. The 1776 chart, what's known as the Sibley chart of the United States, has Pluto at 27 degrees Capricorn. Well, that happens next year in 2020. So you have to understand that what's happened is that 4 years before that, the revolution really began brewing, where everybody's thinking about it, in 1772. Then you had the Boston Tea Party in 1773. Then you had the Battle of Lexington, I think, which was April 19th of, I think, 1774. But all of these astrological buildups are basically showing that Trump and his election and what's about ready to happen with the 2020 election cycle is going to now represent the next American revolution. Because the Democrats, the Democratic primary has become the political equivalent of the Jerry Springer show. It's like, it's just, who could say the most outrageous thing? It's like, I slept with your wife, I slept with your sister, I slept with your brother, I slept with your mother. It's just, I mean, it's crazy. And as the Democrats are just devolving into complete chaos and hell and moving further and further away from any rational thing about, you know, what's going on with America, what you're going to see in 2020 exactly is what happened in 2010 when the Republicans took over the Senate again. Now, not only, and the only reason that the Democrats took over the House was because you had 41 Republicans retire, thinking that they weren't going to get chairmanships anymore, thinking that, well, Trump's an idiot, blah, 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 blah. So they were replaced by 46 Republicans retired, 41 Democrats actually took their place. But when you're talking about Alexandria occasionally coherent, and you're talking about Elon and you know, the squad, I'm almost positive they're all going to get voted out of office in 2020. Now you're going to have a Congress that's going to have Trump Republicans in it that's not going to be run by these jackass milquetoast sons of bitches like Paul Ryan, as an example. And then if you look at the Supreme Court, Ruth Bader Ginsburg is going to die before Christmas. Then after that, Clarence Thomas is now talking about how he's going to retire before the election so Trump can actually appoint him. Sonia Sotomayor is 65 years old but has massive type 1 diabetes. So she may not last another 4 years or so. So you've got the possibility that maybe not this cycle, but at least within the Trump presidency, that Trump is now not only going to have the ability to appoint 180 constitutionalist federal judges, which Obama was just too lazy to actually appoint. Obama didn't do jack crap for anything that he did, for his 8 years. He's not only our worst president, he's probably our laziest president as well. So 180 federal judges, all constitutionalists. He's actually going to get a majority of constitutionalist judges on the Ninth Circuit Court, which is the worst court. It's overturned by the Supreme Court 99% of the time. And now you're looking at an 8-1 majority. Of course, you can't count on Roberts, and you can't count on Kavanaugh. And I'm pretty sure that today they're looking at this whole, well, you're going to get a decision in a few months, but they're looking at this whole thing as to should civil rights actually be extended to gays and trans and, you know, the people who choose a sexual orientation or whatever else. And I'm pretty sure that both Kavanaugh and Roberts, who are both turncoats and wolves in sheep's clothing, are gonna vote with the liberal majority on that, which, again, you can't, it's all equal protection under the law. That's technically fair. Mary Barrett, I think is who it is who I think that Trump is going to, it's my pick, who I think Trump is going to use to replace RGB. Now, Ruth Bader Ginsburg, RBG, sorry. I keep getting her confused with color television. But the 19th is when just weird things are going to come down. Now, let me give you another thing. If anybody used to watch the Kevin Spacey TV series House of Cards, when whatever character he is, he becomes president, but he actually does exactly what it's, there's something, it's like the Frank Rosenthal Act or something. I had it in front of me and I lost it. But he actually then calls out the Marines and calls out martial law and does exactly what it looks like is about ready to happen. So who knows if there's going to be riots, or there's the possibility that maybe Trump does unleash maybe, let's say, 10,000 of the sealed federal indictments that he's got against the Democrats, possibly, along with this entire, it's really ridiculous because this impeachment thing is not only ridiculous, but it's all being held in secret, so it's actually a star chamber impeachment because the Democrats are hanging themselves. Anyway, God bless you. Once again, please, any letters of support for me, melissamorton777@gmail.com. God bless you, JP. Thank you so much for taking the time out of your week to hear what I have to say. Thank you.
Good night, Sean. Good luck.
All right, brother. Bye-bye.